Welcome back to Glendale Today. I'm Councilmember Sam Chavira. My guest for this segment is Glendale's Police Chief, Deborah Black. Chief, welcome and thanks for taking the time to join me today.
Thank you.
Chief, earlier I spoke with Teresa and Kim from Drug Free AZ in the last segment about how drug abuse can affect families. Can you talk about how substance abuse affects the community?
Well, first and foremost, it's the impact of families, and we see it in public safety. You've seen it personally yourself. That tragedy that occurs when abuse is in the home, when you, in worst case scenario, there's an overdose involved. So that's first in my mind, that we need to do everything we can to prevent that harm to families. Secondly, there's a very strong connection to crime. The very possession of drugs is a crime. And then it drives a lot of our crime, property crime, retail theft. A lot of that is directly related to the desire to get the funds, the money to purchase the drugs. So it perpetuates crime in our community as well.
And it's sad that that's a negative effect of that. There are always new dangers out there. What are the new trends that are causing concerns for the department?
Well, really two things. Prescription drug abuse in teens exceeds all use of cocaine, methamphetamine, and ecstasy combined. So prescription drug abuse is the biggest issue we have in Arizona in teens. And the problem is these substances are readily available. A lot of times they're found in a medicine cabinet at home, medicine cabinet at friends' homes, and then again, burglaries. A lot of our burglaries, we find people are going through medicine cabinets to find those substances. The other thing is the synthetic drugs, spice and bath salts. Now we've had some legislation, some new law that will help us with that. But those are the two biggest new threats that we're seeing.
Yeah, you know, whoever thought that your medicine cabinet or even, you know, the corner street down the store could be just as dangerous as, you know, leaving a gun or something unattended at home, you know, with, you know, it's all about education. I know you've really gotten behind Drug Free AZ and their campaign. How is the police department working with this wonderful organization?
So we realize we cannot arrest our way out of this problem, that we really need to help parents get the information they need to protect their kids. I can't promise that their kids will never be exposed to drugs in their community and their schools or whatever. I'll do my best. We have a lot of officers that are dedicated to that work. But we have to make sure that if they are presented that opportunity, that they have the right answer. So Drug Free AZ is very good at delivering that message through parenting programs that they deliver to the schools, and we've worked with them to obtain grants for that. Our SROs have the information and also work within the schools. And we even provided a parenting class for our own employees.
See, that's incredible. You never think about taking care of the caretakers. So yeah. Chief, first of all, I want to thank you for your time, for your service and your commitment to our community. And thank you for being my guest.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching. Kim, Teresa, and Chief Black brought a strong message. I hope you'll be inspired to begin a conversation with your kids. Please consider visiting the drugfreeaz.org website and even enrolling in one of their parenting classes. Drug Free AZ is your partner in raising healthy, drug-free children. See you next time on Glendale Today.